Hello and welcome. My name is Nilaus, and I am joined here today by the illustrious Queen of Biters. Welcome to you, KatherineOfSky.
Oh my god. How am I supposed to respond to that? The Queen of Biters. I am not in league with them, I promise.
Oh, you don't have to. If you're a queen of, you're not in league with. They're just doing your bidding.
I'm the leader of them, right?
They answer to you. That's...
I don't think they do. I don't think... Hey, you know what's wrong with our base?
Not enough lights.
You got it. That's right. We have no lights, and I'm surprised that you haven't gone wild putting them down.
Oh, I did put down a few in the green signs.
You did a few. The smelting is totally dark, though.
Yep.
I wonder if I should put down some solar panels, see how many we've got. Oh, we have a ton.
Yeah, and I also put down 80 in the last episode. So
nice. That is awesome.
It's getting there.
Don't look. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. I see.
What?
That's a very nice sign for don't look here. I observed that most carefully. So I'm wondering, should we build a new solar field like right to the right of that sign where I'm not supposed to look?
Yeah, let's do that.
Do we want to keep on putting them down in the southwest? Because I could put them down. Okay, I'll go down there first.
Let's fill up that area, and then
I've got 106.
Let's select places where it's open ground, so we don't have to clear forest to do it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we want to keep those forests for the trees, for sure.
It's not much of a forest if it isn't for the trees.
Yeah, I know.
Or maybe I'm just being a splitting hairs here.
No, that sounds good. Works for me. I was just thinking of that old phrase. Can't see the forest for the trees. But yeah. But I meant for their pollution absorbing abilities. That's what
yes,
I intended to say, but it didn't quite come out that way. Okay.
Oh no. Iron plates are not exactly great at fueling steam engines with. As far as I know.
Did I put iron? No, I didn't put
I did. Oh, you just put more wood in their boxes?
Wood.
Yeah, you put wood in. Okay, yes. So did I. Just a bit surprised that it was that much. But that's because you also just filled them up with what you had in inventory. Cool.
Yeah, it was just a little amount.
Yeah, well, it helps. Let's see. We're still using those with 300 solar panels. Gotta keep going on this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm putting them down right now. Oh, really, game? Come on.
I am not used to this whole managing the pollution part, but...
I know, but you'd normally just ignore it.
Exactly. And biters, they're just biters, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. When I was a new player, I was like really concerned and put efficiency modules and everything. And now you kind of can't do that anymore.
No, but also the efficiency modules, I'm also like, they are really expensive to produce. I'd like to sort of, what is their return on investment in terms of that, right? I don't know.
Well, I don't know. Yeah, I'm not talking about this series. I'm just reminiscing about, you know, when I first started playing the game. But yeah, we'll have to see if they're going to make sense for us or not. And I think a lot of that may depend on solar panel production and or uranium, because there's not a lot on our map.
Uranium? No, not quite, but that's...
Very tiny, tiny little deposits.
But then solar panel, it's worked before, so it'll...
Oh, yeah,
still
yeah.
Work for us.
They work. Okay.
I'm just scrounging all of the materials off the bus for building.
Okay. I'm not watching. Don't worry.
I know. I'm just letting you know. So if you come back and see someone has pilfered everything, then that's me.
There's nothing there. What happened to production?
But it is actually quite a sad amount we have on our various buses. Mm. It's the only thing that's actually filled up to the end is the copper one.
Wow.
But that, I guess that's also just because anything that passes by the green circuits will not really be demanded by anything else.
Mm-hmm.
Well, let's see. Let's try and see what kind of pattern I want there. Oh, they have such a huge range of the flamer turrets. Completely
nice.
Forgot that. Yeah. Used to remember them as having really short range, but that's not the case.
Hmm. Are you building some right now?
Yep. Can you? You are allowed to look at what I do.
You're putting them way out there.
Why not? Interesting. Why?
Just, I would probably put them right up next to the ammo belt to give them even more range, so that the biters don't even get in range of our.
Gun turrets. But there's a latency between the flamer starts shooting the flames and they actually hits the ground. So if they are trying to, they'll just basically trace after the inbound biters, leaving a trail of fire behind them. So it's only when they stop and start attacking things that the flamers come into effect, which again means why we need the dragon teeth set up.
Ah, I see. Okay.
But that's not getting there until we have robots to do the dirty work for me.
Yes.
So I'd actually like
to we don't want to do that by hand. It's a pain in the socks for sure.
Yeah. And this doesn't require any.
Why is iron so slow? Like, we have full production, but why are we not getting. Oh, because we don't have steel furnaces. That's why.
Ugh. Okay, I get it. I get it. Wait, but do we have research?
No. I'm like, why are we getting half belts? Because, well, it's because that 12 furnace setup is actually for the steel.
But you can get those. And I forgot. You can get those steel. I just
it was not a pressured comment at all. I was just noting, being slightly forgetful. It's okay. It's all good.
But that might be what we should research afterwards, because the tanks are not exactly within reach. It still requires a few more things. So if we can get those, so we can increase our production, especially if the ore on... Yeah, the ore is backed up. So we want to make sure that our bottleneck right now is actually the processing and not the ore in itself. But you don't think they should be this close?
I don't have a lot of experience with them. I used them a little bit in 0.14, but I think you have the most experience, so I will defer to your judgment on that.
Ironically, this is the very first flamer turret I have ever built in my 1,300 hours of Factorio. So
really, congratulations.
Seem like I have the most experience.
Well, you were saying that you have it on your community death world right now.
Yes, but that's but not me building.
I see.
I'm just there trolling.
You're there trolling.
And just being completely awestruck about the 8-lane trains that somehow sprung up in the middle of our Death World base. It's really cool. Wow. And with city blocks and everything, it's really, really cool, the stuff that's been made. And now I get daily reports on, you want to join the fun of chopping down the forest?
I was going to suggest I have a bunch of grenades on me.
Oh,
instead.
Yeah, of course. Well, so do I.
Okay.
I just, oh, no. Oh,
here, I'll give you my set of grenades since you're working on this project.
Shoo. Thank you.
Shoo. Aw, I've been shooed. Yeah. Aw. That's no way to talk to the biter queen.
Well, if this is about two people running around in the forest throwing grenades, I think it's a one-man job, not a two-man job.
Gotcha.
So for everyone's health and safety, it's probably better.
Yeah, it can get a little bit hairy on that last thing for sure.
I don't know about your experience in general about running out in the forest throwing grenades, but mine says it's a one-man thing.
Yeah. Yep, I agree completely.
And now I do this silly thing I always do, and just start on a crusade to build flamer turrets, build something everywhere, because I can't just build at the most important place. I need to build it everywhere. And now I started at the place that has never been attacked instead of the place that gets attacked all the time. Brilliant, huh?
People's ways of doing things. Yeah. It's okay. It's different for everyone. You've got to do it the way that makes you the most comfortable, right?
No. I actually need to do it the way that makes sense.
Okay, so I've rebalanced some of the iron lines. What is holding up this next research? Oh, we're getting attacked in the southeast as well.
Which would really be a great place for me to go then.
Yep. Okay, looks like we're short on iron for green science. That's where we're getting held up in advanced electronics. It's all rebalanced. Eh, can't do much about it then.
That attack in the south, it's not one of those that, all right, it stops, but is that stopped because, yeah, is that because they're now inside the base and munching on our furnaces?
No, it looks like the wall is not broken.
Okay.
I'll go down there and put a second layer of walls, I think, because it's pretty...
It's all right. I mean, I'm heading there anyway.
Are you going that way?
Yeah, perform okay. With the oil, dragging it that way.
Oh, nice. Okay. I will get some... I need repair.
Whoa, that was just rubber banding.
Oh no.
But it was on the, what is it called? Pipes, underground pipes. Suddenly they
rubber banding
just,
on underground pipes. That's
yeah, it jumped back into place. I'm just run dragging it. They jumped back in place. That was nice. Okay. All right. I think this.
Where are the walls? Ah, there are the walls. I'll go and put down some solar panels in that area anyway.
Okay, now this is actually being built slightly closer than okay. What I did before.
You know what I keep finding?
No.
Like somebody randomly keeps dropping wood in these chests and I keep collecting it and putting it on our furnace line.
Okay, well, that's
but
nice.
I don't know who's doing it, and it's quite confusing to me.
But it must be nice that always have some wood available in random places. That must be really nice. I hope you appreciate it, right?
Oh, well, to a degree, I suppose. Oh, my goodness.
Someone almost built right on top of the running path.
Someone?
Yeah, but almost is not quite there, so...
Oh, yes, that could be rough. Oh,
now we're building it correctly here. this makes no sense.
Oh my goodness.
No sense what I'm building.
You might want to change it to a build that does make sense, just saying. Maybe. It's not critical, though. Absolutely uncritical.
Now, I wouldn't mind a teeny tiny little cozy attacker down here just to see if it's working. Oh, there. Thank you. Perfect timing. Now they're coming in on cue.
Oh, my God.
It
that
works.
Is epic. Look at that.
It works.
Nice. I'm impressed. That was good.
They didn't use a lot of materials, that's for sure.
Nice.
I might just build some manual spikes out here. In front of this area, okay. Since this gets attacked all the time. You can see the biters have expanded really close to us.
Wow. Yes, they have.
Yeah, we need tanks.
Yes, we need tanks. We're getting there. We're moving that way, though.
Yeah,
we're doing
absolutely.
Good. Maybe.
Still a couple of hours in the future, for sure. That's the joy of having
you know what
these
we could
expensive
do?
Recipes. Yeah.
We could always increase the speed of the game. So we walk faster, we get materials faster, the biters move faster as well.
I don't like that. I don't like that.
No?
No.
No. I was just checking. Every now and again, there are some interesting suggestions on the Steam forums, and that was an interesting suggestion.
Well, it was like, yeah, just leave the game running overnight.
Like one of this. It's like, can
ow.
I do...
Ow.
Oh, are you owing? No.
Yep. This is why it's a one-man job throwing grenades. Especially when you do it in the point blank.
Oh, I thought the biters were attacking you.
Oh, right. Oh, yeah, biters. Yeah, there was the biters. Sure.
I gave them too much credit, right?
Why am I always throwing grenades at point blank range? I don't know.
I don't know. You might want to just reconsider that tactic, just saying.
It's just so much easier standing in the middle and saying, yep, I want the area around me cleared.
I have this tactic where I just like run and throw them and try to, what do you call it? Just like keep ahead of it. And somehow I managed to clear all the trees within, you know, a couple of tosses. It's kind of cool. Yeah. And it's fast too, really fast.
Yep. But I don't really feel that it works very well in terms of when I'm close to a belt, because then I'll just break all of it.
No.
Oh. I'm not good enough.
I think there's a phrase for that people say, and I don't know if I really like it or not. It's called get good.
Mm-hmm.
It's just tactics. Oh my god, this gun turret has wrong ammo. Take it out.
Oh yeah, lots of them have. I just said, well, that just means it's not being used. I mean,
that's true.
Then it's not really urgent to get it out because clearly that is not the most active turret.
Mm.
And when things come by, then they are ready. Where are we being attacked? We are being attacked at a... Ooh, that's a nice flamer. Flamey thing.
Whoa. The destruction is real. And I'm kind of glad we got flamethrower turrets now.
Yes.
This is working very well. Nice. Wonder,
do they pollute? I guess we'll find out.
Let's see. It's hard to tell. Oh my god, there's a giant biter attack here. No.
Where? What? Why?
Oh, it's ready to come. Okay, so it's all mediums. Oh crap, there's a huge base just formed there. Oh dear. I'm going to put more turrets down if I have any. Oh my god, I have like two turrets.
I don't think I can get there fast enough.
No, they're not attacking right now. They're just planning it.
So you're saying I can't get there in time?
Oh yes. Yes, if you want to. The only problem is a big forest over here. We might have to create a fire break.
Don't really like that idea. We don't want to start fires when we don't need it.
Well, no, that's what I'm saying. I'm saying that we should grenade the trees down here. Like if you zoom in the map where I am. Because otherwise the fire from the flamer turrets is going to spread all the way down.
Okay, and we don't want that to be really good point, though.
Okay, I'll do that. I have grenades. I went and got some after I gave you mine. Let's see. I just want to make sure it's out of the range of stuff.
And now we have flamers all the way down on the...
Oh, nice. Okay, let's get rid of these couple of trees.
Right, I'll start hanging in your direction.
Cool. Did you know that these turrets down here are fed by a box?
Yes. It's better than not being fed by anything. See? Okay. Put it in perspective.
I like your point. That's right. Okay, so I created the fire break so that the fire from the turrets will not spread. All right, cool. Do you want me to start clearing some of these trees for the flamer turrets to be down here?
Well, the flamer turrets will do it themselves. I just need... What am I needing?
I mean, behind the lines, actually.
Engines. More engines.
Okay.
I'll just take all of them. I think we need a lot of... And actually, iron is filling up. Do you ever consider that when you look at a nice bus like this and you have iron all over the place and you're thinking, that's nice. That means we have enough. But when
No, I never think about enough in Factorio. It doesn't exist.
But in terms
I don't
of...
I believe that mythology.
So in terms of... getting back in on traffic and then you're sitting in a motorway and it's just full of cars and you're thinking, that's a nice amount of cars here. This is backfilled. This is the correct. There's no lack of supply of
cars. It just means we need more stuff. We need more places for those cars to go to. We need to go faster. I think that's kind of where we're at. It looks like we're just short on iron for a lot of it. But
I'm also chewing through a lot of it.
We got blue science, right? Just now? Not yet. Oh, no, it's almost there. It's
almost. But we have the first part of it. I've just stolen all of the engines. So that's why they're online. And I'm also stealing all of the good old steel. Should we get the steel furnaces for you?
Yeah.
My present
for me,
to you?
Yes, please. Personally, I need the steel furnaces for my continued existence here.
Good. And I just stole all the steel, so.
A new follower. Okay.
I just had a new follower sound because for some reason Streamlabs is always active and always hooks up to OBS. It's really strange.
Wow.
So if someone follows on Twitch, I get a notify if I have OBS open.
That is so cool.
No, it's not because I'm sitting here recording. I shouldn't get a new follower. Warning.
That is very cool.
But welcome to the Twitch channel, although this has nothing to do with Twitch.
Yes, welcome. I don't even know who you are, but I'm very happy in welcoming you. Yes. It's all good. Hello. Okay, so I rediverted. I rebalanced this again to get more iron down to green science, because that's our biggest bottleneck at the moment. It's just not getting enough iron.
The green science.
But now, green science.
Yep.
Yeah. Did I say blue? I meant green.
No, I don't know what you said.
Who knows what I said? All right. So these engines, are these going to be for blue science or they're for something else?
No, just taking for blue science. I have just stolen 100 for building more of the flamers. So I'll just, let's keep a box of it available.
Oh, you know what I forgot to do last time? Yeah. Is shift all that oil. Whoops.
Shift the oil. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we got to shift the oil out. Gotta move it.
Yeah, that's going to be interesting to look at, to see you do. Okay, your big attack is coming now. Let's, I can't do much except just watch it and hope that it works. That's not bad. They are taking care of things. It barely took a scratch down there. Cool.
Yeah, I'm glad I doubled the wall, though, because...
And,
we could send it to have some more steel as well.
How do I get oil down there? Need to get the oil somewhere, and I need to.
I think they have these things called pipes. Yes. Those usually transport oil fairly well. Okay, or alternatively, you can use barrels if you really want to.
Thank you for the very constructive suggestions. Now, that oil thing you are messing about with there. See, I couldn't take it from there because you just removed. Oh, now I'm watching the silliness that you're doing.
Okay, so there's a reason we're doing this silliness if you guys are watching.
We thank you for including me.
Yes. if you remove a tank, it'll shove the oil into an adjacent tank. Eleonora, please stop interrupting me, my sweet pet. Anyway, it'll move it over, but if it's next to a pipe, it will not shove it through the pipe. So we're doing like this chain of tanks. Eleonora, please.
It's just helping you explain it.
I know. To try to get this moved onward. Oh my god, it does line up. Oh, the luck. Look at that. All right, so I know this looks absolutely ridiculous, but it doesn't quite line up. Oh no.
It almost lines up.
It almost lines up. Well, we can do the last bit with a pump. Right, so I'm just going to remove these guys. See, as they're filling, they go down. Anyway, but it does mostly work. So, right, we want to have enough capacity here. So I want to increase this area so we can hold all the excess anyway. And how to get this here? I need an engine, which we didn't have when we were thinking about this method the other day.
But we do now.
If we do now, so I'm going to grab one and make a pump. So yeah, it was kind of funny. We actually were thinking about this in the last episode when we didn't have pumps yet, or didn't have engines made.
It seems like we're being attacked all the time, consistently.
Ooh. We should talk to the biters about that.
Yeah. Would have complained in with their queen?
Uh-huh, sure. A complaint. Where did this biter queen thing come from? I have no desire to be in with any biters. This is not something that I am in favor of at all. So I want to know who made up this vicious rumor, because it is a vicious rumory part of life. Yeah, it's not good.
I think it's one of those things that, like so many other things, you can just blame on Twitch chat.
On Twitch chat? Okay. All right.
I didn't hear it before.
You know, the thing about it is, when we were last streaming, though, people were there that I know from my channel.
And they're well behaved.
And I'm hurt that they would think of me as the biter queen, because I've never been in league with the biters. So it kind of makes me sad.
I think you're just taking it as a compliment.
Because these are not like random internet people. You know, these are people that I know. And I've
it's your random internet people. It's not like everyone else's random internet people.
Oh my god. Oh my goodness. That cannot be. Okay, so this is almost done, almost drained out. Wow, these pumps are fast. I love
that. Yeah, they're really nice.
The devs did that with pumps to make them, you know, full throughput.
And I also like the boilers. They're also very nice. And now I think that we are again running out of time. It seems like just as we get the ball rolling, we run out of time. But that's
all right.
That's just the essence of Factorio, isn't it?
Indeed it is. Well,
you
better take it down then.
Point where you can stop now?
Absolutely, yes, I'm ready.
Great. So that was another great episode. Thank you very much for joining, and I hope to see you in the next episode. Bye.
See you guys later. Bye.